Yo, 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 Butcher Crunch Army. Where you at? Your motivation guy is back. I ain't going nowhere, man. I'm still here motivating you guys to be great, not only in this game, but also in life. I want you to be the best person you can be. And so I want you to have vision, man. Have big dreams, man. Don't aim small. Aim for the sky. Like, aim for the world. You can do it, all right? I'm back again to bring you guys the latest and greatest tips and tricks that's gonna make you the best Fortnite player you could possibly be. You got secrets? All right, look, we all got secrets. The best thing about Fortnite secrets is how they can give you guys a heads up before anyone else catches wind, thus making you a much better prepared player. So today, we like to share 6 of those secrets. So you cannot go anywhere, man, because I'm telling you right now, it is about to go down. But before we do, grab my favorite candy. What is that, y'all? Help me out. It's that Butcher Crunch, and let's get this going. You know, redwood trees are some of the biggest and thickest trees in the game right now. And unlike normal trees, they don't just disappear after being harvested. Nope, this tree is a bit more dramatic and it comes like crashing down on anybody unfortunate enough to be in the path. This, however, is an excellent opportunity to catch your opponents off guard if you see that they happen to be building in the vicinity. Okay, so aim for the tree and bring it down. Once it comes crashing down, it's also gonna destroy any builds that collides with it. Not only that, if it hits an opponent, it can deal up to 100 damage, which is enough to like break their shields instantly. And so after the deed is done, you can keep harvesting the log for even more wood. Of course, with these weapons, you're gonna want to have some excellent aiming skills. So how about clicking on the link below and checking out Aim Lab? Okay, so Aim Lab is a free-to-play program that allows you to track and train your aiming skills using customizable exercise routines. And the best part about it, guys, is that the skills learned can be used for a variety of different shooter games like Warzone, Valorant, and yours truly, Fortnite. So check it out and see how you can improve your aim today. All right, so Winterfest has opened the door for a variety of new cosmetic items. It's one of like the holiest, jolliest celebrations of Fortnite. With so many secret cosmetics to unwrap at the cabin, there is actually one that's gonna help you guys achieve better FOV when landing. And this is a secret that can help you scan the area when landing and really whenever you feel like rotating. So are you guys ready for the spoilers? Here we go. Well, there's been a shift in the Matrix and as a result, it left a little something in the Fortnite universe as part of Winterfest. And boy, is it a game changer if you guys can get your hands on it. To get this reward, you're going to have to shake a few gifts and open them up at the lodge. Luckily, okay, we know what's in each of these presents without even unwrapping them. So to get this new glider, you need to spot the one with the Matrix wrapping. Open this gift and you're gonna receive the new glider. This glider, guys, takes the shape of the Sentinel from the Matrix. With the mechanical tendrils and the sinister metallic surface, this glider looks kind of intimidating. And it should be, because using this glider actually gives you guys a better FOV. The reason for all of this comes down to design. Like, you can't appreciate a glider unless you can just see it on your screen. So to make the glider more viewable, the FOV is increased when deployed. This gives a great advantage to players just wanting to view more of their landing area as they descend. And so this change of FOV can give you guys an advantage over players using a smaller glider, and as a result, makes it one of the current go-to gliders for competitive games. So there are 2 very minor details that you might not know about sliding. And because we're always in motion, it's not very noticeable. The first is that, you know, the reticles tighten during sliding, and this can allow for more precise shots despite being constantly in motion. The second trick on this list of secrets, guys, is being able to jump midair after sliding. This secret can be extremely useful to know when you need to move after you've already traveled off the edge of a build. You know, you might not have tried this trick before because the thought of taking fall damage or just getting eliminated this way would be embarrassing. However, it can be quite useful if you time it just right. So if you want to test this out, simply just build a ramp and a floor. Now, just keep building floors and build up momentum so you can just slide off the edge. Now, once you've gone over the edge, try jumping and you're gonna find that you can jump up while in the air, giving you some extra distance. And so this can be great for moving around a build and just building higher so you can just keep trying to retake the high ground. Don't underestimate the power, man, that a little extra distance can make when trying to reposition yourself from an angle, okay? You know, interestingly enough, like, we have a 3rd secret to share with you guys involving sliding, and we promise it's the last one for now. Did you know that you can actually slide backwards? Yeah, I just said backwards. This little advantage can be done when redeploying or when you simply have momentum moving you backwards. And so with this in mind, it also is a new way to use sliding to move away from opponents, but still take advantage of the smaller crosshair you get from it. You know, we've seen our fair share of mythics in Fortnite, from the Dragon Breath Sniper to the symbiotes. Some of these items have been vaulted in prior seasons due to their excessive strength and uses compared to the other items in the loot pool. However, one such item is actually quite interesting and can still be found in competitive playlists. I am, of course, ladies and gentlemen, talking about Spider-Man's signature web slingers. This new mythic is an absolute beast for traversing the map quickly. You can enter and exit any fight quickly, and because of this feature, you know, many are calling this the better Spider-Man collaboration. However, there is something that, you know, some players might know about it until they try it. Shooting trees and building can be a great way of getting air. However, latching yourself into a moving vehicle can result in some pretty exciting hijinks. When using this new mythic on a moving vehicle, you can easily just tag along for the ride and just really pursue your opponents. So, surf's up, guys. Meanwhile, just like the comics and movies themselves, Spider-Man wouldn't be who he is today if you couldn't bring objects closer to him with his webs. And that's right, guys. Use the webs to your advantage by harpooning weapons and ammo and healing items closer to you using your webs. Alright guys, so the next secret on this list is another cache item containing loot that you need to survive. Chests are the primary form of gathering weapons and the most common cache that you're going to be looking for when landing. Now, if you're lucky enough, man, you might even be able to spot a rare chest. After chests, ammo boxes can really give you a much-needed boost in ammunition. You know, coolers are often overlooked, especially in today's meta, but contain some pretty useful items to really chill out with. Like these include Chug Splash, as well as Guzzle Juice. The latter of these items has most recently been buffed to heal much faster than it could pre-update. Now, Guzzle Juice has a much quicker and effective capability, making it more on par with the Med Kit and the Med Mist. So, if you're looking for these items, man, then you also just keep an eye out for the coolers, many of which can be found in the desert biomes. So, if you play solo, then you definitely haven't heard about this neat trick. Why is that? Because the conditions for this to become viable only exist in team games. So if you play in a duo or a trio, then odds are, man, that at some point, one or more of you have definitely got downed. During this time, you won't be able to move around as fast, and you're going to be on a time limit before you die and need to be rebooted at one of the reboot bands. So, with Chapter 3, the game has been tweaked a bit, so downed players can do a little bit more than just solely just wander around until they get eliminated or revived. Now, players can opt to drop their loadout and decrease the weight of their inventory. This results in the player being able to crawl away to safety much quicker since they receive a speed boost. This has not only changed the way, you know, getting revived when down, funny enough, like when you have multiple players reviving a downed member of their team, the revive speed will actually be much faster than if one player was just trying to revive them. This means, man, that playing as a team and sticking together is something that you guys gotta be doing at all times. You know, the same applies for the new reboot ban system. Rebooting may take a bit longer than it used to last season. However, you can speed it up when multiple players interact with it at the same time. You know, once rebooted, you're also going to be able to reposition yourself a bit since you no longer respawn on top of the van, and instead, you appear out of a rift in the sky, giving you guys some wiggle room. However, if you have been rebooted, then the last part is no secret. The Foundation is one of the new bosses in Chapter 3, and man, I'm telling you right now, he's a tough foe to take down. However, if you do manage to demolish him in combat, you can be rewarded with the Mythic ADS AR. Now, word on the street is that the Foundation is actually quite easy to take down, and we have the secret formula for doing that right here. Alright, so first and foremost, you want to collect a harpoon gun from one of the fishing barrels. Luckily, the Sanctuary is quite close to the ocean, so your chances of finding one are definitely increased. Next, you're going to want to build up. You're going to need a ramp to move upwards till you're pretty much in the sky. Harvest the nearby trees and rocks for the quickest way of just getting through this process, alright? Build a floor above the foundation and just whip out that harpoon. Aim true and shoot your shot. The foundation will take this normal damage from the utility weapon, however, since you are elevated above him, he will also take damage from the fall downwards, and so this should be a nice chunk out of his health, leaving him vulnerable and just easier to take down. There is also a chance that he will also just not notice you sink the fall down, and also puts him further away from you guys quickly and really cancel out his aggression. And so with any luck, he won't even attack you. Then simply repeat the process and the foundation will be no more. Guys, if you're struggling, you know, having trouble just really in the foundation, then don't forget to visit Aim Lab, all right? You are guaranteed to see improvement as you run through various courses that's gonna unleash your true potential. Punch Chris Army, man, that is gonna be all for me. Your motivation guy, Keith Allen. I'm proud of you guys. Don't give up on your dreams. Keep going, apply these tips, and you're gonna see yourself go to the next level. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, and feel free to let us know in the comments down below what you guys want to hear next. We'll see you on the next one. Peace.